Glory, hallelujah. The Lord bless you this Friday, the 24th day of March 2017. The glory of God will open new things for you, new adventure, new opportunities, new blessings, new connection in the name of Jesus. You will not be stranded. You will go from glory to glory. You will go from power to power in the name of Jesus. Every burden in your life be removed right now by the power of the Holy Spirit. In the name of Jesus, it is done. In Jesus' name, amen. You are welcome. This is Joseph Adenuga, the pastor of Prevailing Church of Christ, Bethlehem, South Africa. As usual, I'm here to bless you with the word of God. You know, it's one of the duties, core duties that God gave me, to daily broadcast messages to people all around the world about some of the revelations he gave to me. Hallelujah. And I believe that this message is going to bless you in the name of Jesus. Today, I want to continue from where I stopped yesterday. You know, yesterday, I am talking about the importance of knowing who you are. The importance of knowing who you are. And I'm going to take my text today from the book of Romans chapter 12. And I'm going to read from verse 4. And I want you to listen. If you have your Bible, as you listen to this message, you can open your Bible. Romans chapter 12, I read from verse 4. For as we have many members in one body, and all members have not the same office, so we, being many, are one body in Christ, and every one members one of another. Having then gift differing according to the grace that is given to us, whether prophecy, let us prophesy according to the proportion of faith, or ministry, let us wait on our ministering, or he that teacheth on teaching, or he that exhorteth on exhortation, he that giveth, let him do it with simplicity, he that ruleth with diligence, he that showeth mercy with cheerfulness. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. This place is talking about the church of Jesus. Hallelujah. He's saying that the church of Jesus Christ is one body. But in our body, there are different members. We have the mouth, we have the eyes, we have the nose, we have the hand, we have the leg, we have the belly. And inside us, there are so many parts of our body, the intestine, the spleen, the heart, and so many kinds of things. We have the bone. Our body is one body, but is a combination of different members. And all these members are working in unity and harmony to produce a healthy person. Immediately, one member of our body is suffering, the whole body will suffer. Hallelujah. So you are a member of the body of Jesus Christ, but you are different from other members. But even though we are different, we are all equally important. You have to understand that. You must know who you are. And the reason why you must know who you are is that if, for instance, you are the eyes, you cannot envy the mouth, that only the mouth is taking the food. Now, your eyes now say, no, I want to taste that food. If that food should get to your eyes, your whole body will be discomfort. We have discomfort. Because the eyes is not meant to take in the food. Only the mouth is meant to take in the food. And when you feed the body through the mouth, and the mouth is taking the food, it's going to supply the nutrient to every part of your body. Hallelujah. So what I'm saying is that you need to locate and to know who you are and stay there where you are. Don't make any attempt to be like somebody else. Because if you try to be like somebody else, you are not going to excel. Because you are going to be abandoning the real purpose for which you are here. Hallelujah. So, but we need mentors. I'm not talking about mentoring. Because we need mentors to challenge us and to motivate us to become better. Hallelujah. But you see, when we have a mentor, in order to be like our mentor, we're going to be missing the very, very, you know, important part of us that we need to let out to be a blessing to the world. If I want to be like you, I am going to miss out the fun of being myself. Hallelujah. Now, you know, you must understand that you are who God says you are, and you must just stop on that and try as much as possible to develop the you. Develop the you to be better and not to try to be like somebody else. Because if you develop the you and you are the better you that God made, then the better you are, the more of a blessing you will be to your generation. Yesterday, the Spirit of the Lord is asking me to tell you yesterday that you are the salt of the earth. When you discover who you are and you become a better you, then that salt is going to be much more enjoyable by your world. The salt in you is going to affect your world more positively because you are becoming a better you. So the salt in you is going to preserve more, is going to heal more, and is going to sweeten more. And the light in you is going to shine bright and bright. Hallelujah. For instance, if there are different types of bulb light bulb, there are some small bulb of 30 watts, there are some bulb of 60 watts, there are some bulb of 100 watts, then we have some bulb in fluorescent. We have some fluorescent lamp. They are also like bulb, but they are fluorescent. Hallelujah. All these bulbs give different energy of light. Hallelujah. So if a 30 watts bulb want to give the kind of energy light that 100 watt bulb is going to give, that 30 watt bulb is going to run out soon because it does not have the capacity to produce 100 watts. It is created to produce 30 watts. And Jesus said it in his own parables. He said, some people are giving 5 talents, some people are giving 2 talents, and some people are giving 1 talent. The person that is giving 1 talent is not hated. He doesn't love the one that he gave 5 talents more than the one that he gave 1 talent. But what he expects of you is to trade with your talent and make profit with your talent and be a blessing to yourself and be a blessing to the kingdom of God and be a blessing to your fellow humankind. And that is why God sent you here. You must understand it. When you understand this, then you are going to stay in your position and improve yourself and become better and be a blessing to your generation. I'm going to stop there. Thank you for listening. And I believe that God's blessing is flowing in your life. Receive the blessing of God. Let the power of God begin to make way for you where there is no way. In the name of Jesus, it is done. Hallelujah. Thank you for listening. This is Joseph Adenuga, the pastor of Prevailing Church of Christ, Bethlehem, South Africa, signing out right now and saying, be blessed and remain blessed.